Nithya Mandam, let's start the power manifestation session. Sit straight, visualize Bhagwan in your third eye, and let's start with the Sadguru Vandanam. Nityanandam Paramasukadam Kevalam Yanamurtim Vanvaditam Gagana Sadasham Tatvamasya Dilakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvadi Sakshi Bhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami. Nityanandam, welcome to Sri Kailasha Courtyard Manifesting Past Session. Welcome everybody. Such an intense Diksha, Darshan and powerful cognition for us to really start living the space of Sri Kailasha. Swamiji beautifully describes 100 people around him living with the Master, the ultimate space of oneness, and 10,000 people around the world living with the Master, again, in beautiful space of oneness, just living the Atma Tattva, the core of your beliefs. What are your core beliefs about you, about the world, about others, and about life? If you see your identity, how you are choosing the resources outside you or inside you. Whenever we choose the outside, we fall into the violence. Again and again, negotiating with our core beliefs ourselves and having a conflict. When we choose the inner space, the space of Paramashiva, the core beliefs, the Paramashiva in us is guiding us, is taking us through every step, believing even now he is only doing it through us and understanding and deciding as per what Swamiji really wants you to become. That is the pure love and Tyaga Swamiji beautifully described to us. If we say the core of the belief is based on your identity, your skills, your idea of you and whatever identity of you or identity of others, others are not nice, they are not going to help you, or in old age, how you're going to manage everything, whatever you have about the identity of others and identity about life. Oh, life is miserable. Life is really creating problems and you're struggling with life. Body, with life, with others, everything what we are, core resource of us is residing in only the space of Paramashiva, again and again aligning back the Dhrida Buddhi consistently, unbrokenly, having the oneness with Paramashiva in every action, every thought. How beautifully he said, the disciples, how they continuously hold him as a highest cognition, and his words as his lifestyle in every action they do. And how Swamiji himself, Atma Pramana, how he lived around Arunagiri Yogeshwara, changing his letter A to be Arunagiri Yogeshwara from his father's and his grandfather's name. Such a beautiful space of really cherishing those little things inside you in every action. Again and again, that Paramashiva is real and he is the one who's manifesting even a cup of coffee, and thanking him for even a cup of coffee or making a big decision or finding a password in your laptop. Anything, just making the whole space only for Paramashiva to manifest around you. Simply, you're living in the highest reality of oneness with Paramashiva. Now, with that core belief of Atma Tattva in completely in oneness with Paramashiva and manifesting our reality now. So let's get into the Shastra Pramana that he has given today. Oh.
The Shastra Pramana for the power of depth dimension is taken from the Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, Sutra 59, Dharana 36. Gathadi bhanjane drishtim bitti styaktva vinikshipet tulyam takshanat gatva tallaya tanmayo bhavet. Gatadi bhanjane drishtim bitti styaktva vinikshipet tulyam takshanat gatva tallaya tanmayo bhavet.
Such a beautiful sutra, Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, Sutra 15.36. Just fix your sight through the third eye, inside the pot or any other object with a single pointed awareness, dropping the idea of object having any length, breadth, depth, enclosure, characteristics, form, shapes, support, any of the identities that we hold about the object. Not only because we hold the identity for us, we hold identity for every object that we see, every person we see. When we drop the identity of us and understand we are Paramashiva, start living only from the heart, from the mind is only violence. From the perception is only violence. From the mind, continuously living in the space of oneness with Paramashiva and manifesting Paramashiva in everybody, seeing Paramashiva in everybody, in everything, what is around us, opens up and dissolves the mind, and simply yogi has absorbed into the depth of the objects instantaneously, enter into the space of uniting and absorbing into complete oneness happens. So beautifully, Swamiji said once, when you look at the flower, stop thinking it is a flower. Stop thinking it has petals, it has colors, it has perfume, it has stem, zero. Everything just go into the space of, oh, it is Paramashiva happening out there. That is why it is radiating the beauty. And you are Paramashiva. Only beauty. Both sides, when you start understanding, everything is a happening of Paramashiva, the Atma Tattva, continuously, unbrokenly holding this space, makes us manifest, become oneness with the object, oneness with Paramashiva. And whatever is the Akasha, the five Bhutas that Swamiji said, the earth element, the water element, the fire element, the air element, and the ether, which is the ether is the Akasha, which is the consciousness, which is there in us continuously. How the water showers and simply makes everything happen, and how rain changes the whole mental setup. How beautifully Swamiji described how these great kingdoms lived only on consciousness as the ultimate goal, where everything merges and everything creates the ultimate reality of oneness. Living from the space of Paramashiva, doing even the smallest things, and giving up the identity of outer world, which is constantly throwing violence at us. If we give the key to the violent people, they obviously are going to open our door. If we do not give the key, we do not give the rights to others to disturb us, there is no disturbance going to happen. The Atma Tattva is the ultimate reality. Paramashiva space in us is the only reality that we experience. Living on the experience of oneness with Paramashiva in every action, in every thought, in every word is the only reality that we need to do. That is the ultimate resources that Swamiji said, I measure everybody by their resources, how they use it. As your identity or others' identity or life identity is only the space of Paramashiva. Enjoying Paramashiva, celebrating Paramashiva in Paramashiva, and continuing happening in Paramashiva is the only resources we came here to enjoy. All other resources, Swamiji himself will manifest around us with abundance in wealth, in relation, in every dimension of life. It is okay to struggle, but he himself will manifest, remove the struggle and raise us to the higher reality. and ultimately the struggle will disappear. A struggle is not violence, Swamiji beautifully said. He will remove that also for us when we are aligned to the Atma Tattva, the inner core beliefs that we decide to live as the ultimate reality. Here in the sutra, he's just dissolving us into the oneness of Paramashiva and manifesting as reality. Now we'll go to the instruction. We are going to do the depth dimension today. So the depth dimension of asking any plants, if you have a plant, that will be the best. If you can sit under a tree, or if you can have a pot of plant in front of you and keep it in the front. If you have a camera, you can set it up, or you can take a picture now. And simply, you can see how beautifully it just starts listening to us and manifest the reality, how they get connected to the ultimate. Get absorbed into the plant with the understanding Swamiji is moving everything, the whole universe, everything outside, inside of all bodies. From the space, I am Paramashiva. Ask Swamiji to move the plant, drop a leaf or a flower in front of you. If you do not have any plant, you can have any solid non-rolling object, little heavy, and keep it front of you and ask it to move. On the silicon, you can have, if you're keeping it on a silicon, make sure you switch off the silicon completely off or remove the battery and then place the object, which is not just rolling, which is stable. Now, let's sit and enjoy the space of Paramashiva with such an intense darshan, diksha, and such a celebration space of oneness with Paramashiva. Sit straight, visualize Swamiji, the darshan and diksha again and again. Contemplate on the great stories and truths and beautifully presented by Swamiji for us to grasp the highest cognition. Just contemplate on that so that the mind does not run to your household things or office or anywhere. Just being in the space of Paramashiva, the satsang that you just heard from Paramashiva himself, and chant the Mahavakya continuously and unbroken. Just listening to the Mahavakya continuously, the tune of Swamiji, and chanting that and making your whole being vibrate with that in a deep listening and a deep joy and romance with that Mahavakya simply will make you manifest. Once the Mahavakya is over, you can take a picture or you can, the recorded, you can upload it. Right now, let's sit straight, visualize Swamiji, continuously contemplate on the great truth that Swamiji just revealed in from the Sri Kailasha space of Paramashiva. And let's visualize Swamiji in your third eye. Be in oneness with Swamiji, the darshan that he just gave, and chant the Mahavakya. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Shivoham, Om Nitya. Namashivoham Om Nitya
Om Nityananda
Sadashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham
Nityananda
Sadashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham
Om Nityananda
ஆனந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம்
பரமசிவோஹம்
Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham
Such a beautiful space. Such a beautifully, Swamiji says, the how we exist as pure positivity, we become a leader, we are pure possibility, then we are Devata's God. If we are pure power, the ultimate oneness with Paramashiva, we become Mahadeva himself. Such beautiful revelations, and us manifesting the powers and experiencing that oneness as Mahadeva is the power manifestation. So go ahead and share that beautiful space with everybody in the world. Sharing is one of the most important part of the spiritual routine, because when we share, we reiterate our space and tell the world what we cherish, what our core beliefs are. And sharings at Sri Kailasha Kotiyar Manifesting Power Group, you can share your experiences, your manifestation here today or in the outer world, that whatever Swamiji has manifested through you, share it with as many groups as possible and invite them for the satsang. One darshan, one meditation, just call them for meditation and see what happens in their life, and just challenge them how they're going to feel after that meditation. It's the ultimate oneness which happens even if the person is completely new. So share it as many group as possible. But you start cherishing yourself more and more and more when you share. If you have not manifested, you can pick up any of those beautiful manifestation of Leelas of Swamiji and share it with the world. If you have manifested, share your post with the world. Again and again, Swamiji beautifully says, enriching is liberating yourself from this world. And literally, the causing happens when you are in the anugraha. You are consciousness. You start living enlightenment is causing us as another person who's also experiencing the same enlightened space. So such a beautiful space Swamiji has given for us and created a group where all over the world, the people are beautifully sharing all their beautiful space of Swamiji with us. So please go ahead and invite them for the next satsang. Such a beautiful, wonderful space that Swamiji has created. And for the kids, there's Nityananda Gurukul. You can enroll your kids into 2 hours a week to experience these powers. Just 2 hours a week, and they will start experiencing phenomenal powers that will pull them closer and closer to Swamiji, making them manifest the Paramashiva space very easily. How the kids learn yoga so fast, they start with Sirasasana first. Like that, they will start with power manifestation, the ultimate space of oneness, very easily. So if just 2 hours you can spend for your child connecting to the highest reality, you can enroll your child into Enlightened Kids. And if you are interested, please go ahead and share the Acharya registration new so that you can also be part of that. Such a wonderful space that Swamiji has created for all of us to enjoy the ultimate space of oneness. So, such a beautiful space. Let's bow down and surrender all this great, powerful cognition and power manifestation to Swamiji's lotus feet. Anything which happens in your life or doesn't happen, just go on surrendering to Swamiji's lotus feet, and with a deep seeking and prayerful space in gratitude for everything happening in your life. Every breath is a gratitude for us. That is the most important thing we need to understand. If there is no breath, we are not here. So with every breath in deep gratitude, requesting Swamiji to make Tyaga the highest possibility, Atma Tattva, as your core belief, requesting with deep, prayerful and seeking more will make it as a reality. So let's, with that, visualize Bhagwan in your third eye, and in deep surrender, let's end with the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Paramashivam Padukarpanamastu. Om Nityanandam. Thank you so much. Thank you, Swamiji. See you in the next satsang. Don't miss any of the satsangs and power manifestation. Thank you, Nityanandam.